In this video, I will give you an introduction to the BlueSpice 3 user interface and its main functionality. I'm using our public demo wiki since everyone who is interested has access to it. I encourage you to look around our demo after this video if you have a little time. On the left side, you find the navigation that gives you quick access to the most important pages on your wiki. Here we have the main navigation open, which can be customized by a user with admin rights. Next, there is the Books tab, where BlueSpice Pro users can access and manage the books they create from their wiki pages. We'll get to that later. Each user has a personal navigation, sort of a bookmarks bar. This personal navigation is edited by each user individually. This is done using wiki text formatting, but you really only have to do it once to understand the syntax. Let's make a quick change. One asterisk creates a menu header. I then simply enter a page name in double brackets to create a link and put two asterisks in front to mark it as a menu item. The last tab is called Global Actions. Here you can access pages important for wiki maintenance tasks. Administrators see additional links to administrative pages, such as the Configuration Manager. From here, I can also access all built-in special pages that are important for maintenance tasks. In the main toolbar is the search function, which is powered by Elasticsearch and ensures that users can find the information they need. So let's try it out. I'll look for a rather generic term such as documentation. As I am typing, the extended search menu starts returning matches on the left. On the right, I could now also create a page with that name, since it doesn't exist yet, at least not in the main namespace. I do see that it already exists as a subpage of another page called Your Company, however. On the right, the search also returns further close matches to my actual search term. I'm not creating a new page here, but instead hit Enter to load the Search Center where I can fine-tune my search. Right away, I see two so-called pills, namespace and category. They show me where all these search results come from, and at the same time, I can filter my results. I can select some additional filters by using so-called semantic properties that are either built in or have been created by an admin user. Here I select Page Creator, then a user, and drill down deeper by eliminating some categories. We can further specify the search order or export the filtered search results, which can then automatically be added to a book, for example. I can also mark a search result as important for me. Next time I search for documentation, this result will have more weight in the search results. In addition, users can set for themselves which namespaces they want to include in their search. They simply go to their preferences in their user menu, select the Extended Search tab, and add or remove namespaces. What are these namespaces anyway? Namespaces are used in the wiki to organize pages. They can also grant special access permissions to a group of users. Some of the namespaces are built in, like file or template, for example, while others are created by admin users. Each namespace can have different configurations. For example, you can set for each of them if you want to work with page drafts that require approvals of users with reviewer rights. In the Permission Manager, an administrator assigns rights to user groups in these individual namespaces. These rights are encapsulated in different roles. In this wiki, the group User can read and edit pages in all namespaces. The group SysOp has, in addition, the roles admin and maintenance admin, with all kinds of rights necessary to manage the wiki. Users are then assigned to one or more groups in the user manager. Instead of creating users directly in the wiki, you can also connect BlueSpice to an LDAP server for central authentication. Now let's create a new wiki page. I can create an empty page, or if my wiki administrator has created some page templates, I choose a template. Here I pick empty page. Let me add some text. Now, since I'm creating this page in the main namespace, I want to tag it with a category so that it is easier to find the page later if I have a large number of pages in my wiki. I can follow the link to the category and see that this is the first page in this category. However, another user has already tagged an image with this category. We are off to a good start. But let me show you how to use Visual Editor for page editing. I can then use shortcuts to format the text or to insert links, for example. Here I created a so-called red link. This is a link to a page that doesn't exist yet. It is shown in red and tells another user that there should be a page for this topic. Any editor can then click on this link and create that page. We can also very easily insert media files such as images. I first look at what's already available in this wiki for Wheel Hub Assembly. I think I have a better image. So I upload it by browsing my file system or simply dragging it here into the upload box. I can quickly add a caption to the image and alternative text for users who rely on screen readers. I then format and position the image on the page. I can also insert any templates that exist in my wiki, like a little info box. You can find the source code for such a template on the BlueSpice help desk if you want to use it. A little hidden here, under magic words, I can also directly insert a Drawio diagram on the page. Drawio is an open source diagramming tool and well documented on the Drawio website. I'll grab a quick example from them. And put it on my page. When working with big diagrams like that, I can set the wiki to full size mode. Once I'm done editing, I change it back to the regular display mode. And the diagram resizes nicely. You can also switch from visual editing mode into the source code mode and work directly with wiki text. This is mainly useful for users with admin rights who create dynamic templates that use variables, for example. Now, there are lots of things I can do with this page. I can add it to an existing book, export it to PDF, and even distribute a QR code for it. This comes in handy if you have product inventory and you manage the documentation for it in your wiki. In a wiki environment, it is very important that all changes users make to a page are tracked so that it is easy to compare versions and roll them back if necessary. This is done with the version history of a page. Clicking on the edit date in the title section brings you to a comparison of the latest two versions of this page. You can view the changes in visual mode, in wiki text, or in a classic view that shows the changes in two columns. I can cycle through the history to see how the document changed with each version. I can click on any version to see what the page looked like then. And finally, I can roll back the current version to any version that existed before. Let's talk a little bit about quality management. Sometimes it is necessary that content in a wiki is managed by some sort of a review process. To facilitate this, you can enable approvals in a namespace. Pages with the approval feature show the associated status information. When an editor makes a change, the page is put into draft status and waiting for a reviewer to accept the page. An editor also has the option to kick off a review workflow and invite other users to review the page before it is published. When the review workflow is finished, the workflow can be configured to automatically accept the page. I can also expire a page if it is no longer valid. This adds a watermark to the page and puts it on the expiry list. Users can then look at the list of expired pages and decide how the page should be updated or archived. From the quality management toolbar, you can also set a reminder for this page, either for yourself or for another user. Users then receive a notification on the due date in their notifications or via email, depending on their preferences. Page assignments allow you to specify users that can edit the page independent of their privileges on other pages. A user who only has read permissions on the wiki can now also edit this particular page. On each page, users can also add attachments, such as Word files or spreadsheets. Or they can start a discussion about the page. The discussion topics of each page are shown collectively on the special page timeline. This timeline can be filtered. So let's go ahead and set some filters. The filter is then shown in the browser's address bar and can be used to integrate the filtered results permanently into any other wiki page. You can also have a general blog page where users can create discussions independent from a particular wiki page. If you then add the latest timeline results or blog posts on the main page of your wiki, you have a nice social feature that connects everybody who is working with the wiki. Let's not forget about the book functionality. Each wiki page can be added to a book, and users with appropriate rights can create and edit new books. Pages are added individually, or in bulk, for example, by selecting a category. I can then organize the pages in the book. The book can easily be exported to PDF. If a user lands on a page that is part of a book, the book navigation is automatically loaded with the page and the user can read through the book. I wouldn't want to end without talking a little bit about Semantic Mediawiki, which also comes with BlueSpice Pro. With Semantic, you can collect structured data which you can then query on your wiki or export to allow other systems to use this data seamlessly. It even allows you to aggregate geographical data onto interactive maps such as Google Maps. Pages that use Semantic usually include a form that collects some of the information on a page. This form can be created by any user with admin rights. The display of the form data on the page can be defined in a template. In addition to the form, the page can still have regular free text that is editable in forms mode or in regular edit mode. And this is it for our first overview. I hope that I was able to show you the potential of BlueSpice Pro for your collaborative documentation needs. Of course, we'd love to work with you to make sure that you have the necessary tools to make all of your knowledge projects as successful as you envision them. Don't forget to try out our BlueSpice demo at demo.bluespice.com. A test login is provided on the start page of the demo.